Hello and welcome to this session. This is the next part of Postman Crash Course and I hope you have seen the earlier parts. In this part, we are going to learn about scripting and testing and debugging and troubleshooting, and this is going to be very easy and very interesting. You can follow this on Windows or Mac operating systems. So let's get started and I will go to my Postman. And in Postman, we can create scripts and there are multiple places where we can create scripts. For example, we can create a script at collection level. We can also create scripts at folder and request level. So I will create a new collection. I'm going to create a new collection and I will name it as, let us say, demo and create. And now if you go to this demo collection and if you go to edit, you will find two sections here where you can add the scripts, and these sections are the pre-request script section and the test section. Now here, if you write anything, any script in the pre-request script section, this gets executed before we run the request, and any scripts that you add in the test section gets executed after we receive the response. So let us say in the pre-request script section, I will say console.log, and this is JavaScript which is used in Postman. Just in case you are not very familiar with JavaScript, you can go to my website, that is automationstepbystep.com, and here if you go to the programming section, you will find a tutorial on JavaScript. So this is for absolute beginners, you can learn JavaScript from here. So here I will say console.log, this is to print something on the console, and here in brackets I will give double quotes and I will say I am inside collection pre-request script section. So this will print on the console. Similarly, let me copy this and I will go to the tests section and I will again say console.log, I am inside collection, and here I will say I am inside collection test or test section, and that's it. I will say update. And now inside this collection, I'm going to create a folder. So I will click on these three dots and I will say add folder. And here I can give any name to my folder. I will say this is sample. And you can see here again, we have pre-request script and test section. So I will also show you the priority. What is the priority of scripting in collection, folder and request? So I will again say here, I'm inside folder pre-request script, and then I will copy this, go to test section, and here I will say I am inside folder, and I will say here test section, and I will say create. So this creates a folder, and you can see here is the folder created. Now I can add a request. So I can create a new request, or let me go to the history, and from here I can select some earlier requests that I have executed. So if I see here, we have get request. I'm just going to click on this plus icon so that I can add it. I will say this is get user request, and here I'm going to add it to my demo collection inside the sample folder. So I will say save. If I go to my collections, you can see the request is here. Now again at the request level, we have these two sections, pre-request script and test. I will go to the pre-request script, and here I will say I'm inside request pre-request script, and then in the tests section I will say, so there is some test already created. I'm just going to have only this statement, console.log, I'm inside request, and I will say here test section, and now I can save, and now I can run the request. So these are the three levels you can create: at collection level, folder, and then at a request level. And the priority is also the same. So here, whatever pre-request script you have at collection level will run first, then we have at folder level, and then the request level. And when the request gets executed and we get the response, the test script will also get executed in the same order, that is collection, folder and request. Let us see this in action. I will open the show Postman console from here. You can also click on this icon to open the Postman console. And I will also split my screen so that you can see my Postman window and the console window. So now I have saved my request and I'm going to send it, and you will see the logs here, and here you can see this is how it gets executed. First it is executing the script inside the pre-request section of collection, then folder and request, then we have the actual request getting executed, and you can see this. And once we have got the response, then we have the test scripts getting executed again in the same order, collection folder and requests. So this is how we execute, we add and execute scripts. So I'll just clear this and close the Postman console. And now if you see here, the test section is where we can also add our tests, because this will get executed after we receive the response, and we can make use of this to add our tests as well. And here if I go to the test section, you will find we have some snippets here. So you can see here are some snippets or test scripts that you can directly add. So you can just go to the line where you want to add. For example, I will go to this line, and now from here I can select any test snippet. For example, I will say status code is 200, and as I click here, this test is added. I can again select some more test. For example, I select this, response time is less than 200. So I should be keeping my cursor on the line where I want to add the test, and then I can click here, and you can see the test is added here. Now if I save and send my request, you will see in the response we have got this section test result, and if I go here, you can see both my tests are passed. And here, just in case if I change this to something else, for example I say I want to check the status code is 201, this will fail. And if I send it now, you will see it has failed, and this is how we get the response. Now if I run this in a collection runner, if I go to this and say run, so it opens a collection runner window, and here I will again select my collection and folder, and I will say run, and here you can see it has executed, and again it shows us the status of our test. And if I go to the summary, you can see again I can see the pass and failed here. So this is how you can create and run the tests. And here you will also find a link. So if I go to my request here, here is a link, learn more about test scripts. You can go here, this will open the Postman documentation, and here you can see test scripts and some examples. So you can see some examples here. If you go to this test examples, here you will see some more examples how you can create tests. So this is going to be very easy and very handy. Now we have learnt about scripting and testing, let us see debugging and troubleshooting in Postman. So in Postman, to do debugging and troubleshooting, the best way is you can open the Postman console. You can go to view and say Postman console, or you can click on this button here, this will open Postman console, and here you can get all the logs. You can clear the logs, and then you can also filter out the logs with log info warning and error statements. I will show you this. So for example, let me run this request. I will say save and send, and you can see all the requests, all the logs are here. And here you can expand the request so that you can see all the network details, request headers, response headers, and the actual response body as well. So you can see this is the response body. You can click here and you can see the response body like this as well. And then if you go to the top, you will see show raw log. If you click here, this will show you the actual request that went to the server and the actual response that we received from the server before Postman could implement its formatting. So you can see the raw logs as well here, and then I will click on show pretty logs, so it will show you the formatted logs. Now here I can also create some log statements. For example, I will go here, you can create the scripts in the pre-request script section or the test script section, anywhere. So for example, I go to the test script, and here I can say, so we have different levels or different types. I can say console.log, and I will say this is a log. Then I will say console.info, and here I will say this is an info, and to print a warning I will say console.warn, and I will say this is a warning, and to print an error I will say console.error, and I will say this is an error. So if I now save this and run this, I'll open the Postman console as well, and I will clear everything here and save and send my request. And here you can see all the log statements, and then you can do the filters from here. For example, I do not want to see error, you can do like this, or I do not want to see the info logs, you can filter out from here. Now, if you want to go a little more deep, you can go to your view, and here we have developer, and then here we have show dev tools. Go here, and here you can see all the app logs, and then you can go to the console and see all these logs. You can see the network logs, memory logs, application logs, all these logs you can see. And here you can say perform a request or hit F5 to record the reload. So you can also check all these logs from here, and then you can do the troubleshooting. So this is how quickly you can do debugging and troubleshooting in Postman. I hope this part of Postman crash course was very useful for you. Do watch the next part as well and share your knowledge with everyone, and let me know how do you like this part of Postman crash course. Stay happy, keep learning, and thank you for watching.